In India, we're seeing this huge gender gap when it comes to COVID vaccines. The women are lagging far behind. What can be done, you know, to actually bridge this gap? And why do you think there is this difference?
Yes, well, we know some of the reasons for this because we've talked to some of the women about it. And partly there are some myths out there about the impact of the vaccine on women. Particularly, so we've heard myths that many women think that if they have the vaccine, it will make them sterile, or it will affect them somehow when they're menstruating, both of which are not true. And so there's quite a lot of misinformation, I think, that is in the community. So one thing we need to do is make sure that women hear very directly that this will not have anything to do with causing you sterility. And countering those myths with a barrage of information, really, both verbal and also in writing and also through TV and the media. The media has a big role to play in what we call risk communications. But there are also some cultural issues around the reasons that women are not getting vaccinated yet as much as men. And some of those things are, it's hard for, many women don't have access, for example, to digital technology, yes, so they can't register online. Yes. That's another large issue that needs to be taken into account. And then also it's harder often for women to travel to a vaccine centre unless they have male partners with them.
So the support.
Yes, the families need to get behind them and realise that everyone in the family needs to be involved. And that's then when it comes down to the family level as well and some of the cultural barriers that exist in the family, sort of prioritising men as the first recipients and not women.
Yeah.
So, you know, again, it's this multi-pronged issue that, and each of those things can be addressed, but it does need a partnership with the health system, the government, NGOs, the UN, whoever can help work together on these things.
Yeah.